Hello everyone, my name is Rachel and I'm the founder and CEO of Organize It, the one-stop shop for all your cooking needs. People use recipes in order to cook, and recipes come from a huge variety of places, from cookbooks and magazines and handwritten notes, and obviously lots of websites. And eventually this is how it looks, a huge mess. Can you find here anything? No. Can you take it to the store with you when you are shopping and you want to make sure you have everything you need for some dish? Good luck with that. So, being a mobile developer and also a home cook myself, I made a solution for this problem. A place where you can easily store all your cooking information in a digital format, easily accessible and searchable, and you can take it with you everywhere you need it. This is Organize It app. And I know what you're thinking now. There are so many recipe apps. So another one, why? Well, no, we are not another recipe app. We have a unique approach and a technology that completely changes the way people collect recipes. And let me explain. So the idea is, instead of typing in your recipes, like I discovered most apps expect you to do when I was looking for a solution for my own recipes, which is very hard and annoying, instead of that, you can simply take a picture, a photo, or a screenshot of any recipe, and then we apply OCR, optical character recognition, in order to extract the text from this photo. So far, these are all pretty mature standard technologies, but here comes the cool part. We have an algorithm that we're working on that knows how to understand the context of this text. And he knows to look at the text and say, okay, that's the ingredients, that's the steps, that's the quantities. And the result is enabling the user in a single click to capture and scan a fully structured recipe that can come from everywhere. That's the second coolest part, because it can work with any possible website, cookbook, as long as you can take a screenshot or a photo of it. We released this app 2 years ago on the iOS App Store. We were completely bootstrapped, no marketing budget, and let's see what happened. Did people like it? Oh yes, they loved it. So far, we've generated 130,000 organic app downloads, with 35,000 monthly active users who store almost 2 million recipes in our platform. People love it so much and it is so useful for them that some of them even upgrade for the premium version of our app, and until now we've generated almost $100,000 of premium version sales. Why is that? How do we grow our audience? Well, the first condition of course is having a great product that people really love and use. But in addition, I've been a mobile developer for many years and I launched several dozens of apps, and I know how to make an app to stand out. So if you'll search the US App Store, for example, for a recipe organizer, we'll come second out of more than 5,000 apps. And it brings us a lot of organic traction. But then since we are profitable, we also are using promoted ads with the cost of user acquisition, $1.16. How large is the audience for what we do? How many people are interested in online recipes? There are 300 million people worldwide who are interested in and use online recipes. This is a very big audience, and the recipes stand at the gateway of their interaction with grocery shopping, meal planning, and cooking, which opens lots of monetization opportunities. And now I want to talk about money, monetization. How do we intend to monetize recipes? One way that I already mentioned is selling premium subscription. The second stage of our monetization plan is introducing grocery orders from our users' recipes directly to online stores and delivery services. The third stage of our monetization plan is to use sponsor product placement. When someone places an order from his recipe, the default choices for his order will be of sponsored brands. We are also talking to smart kitchen device manufacturers in order to integrate our platform into their devices and bringing them the value of people's personal cooking information on their smart kitchen devices. And this is all not just a theoretical plan. we are actually doing it. So I mentioned the premium subscriptions that we're selling. These are the actual data of our sales, daily average sales for the last 2 years and the last 3 weeks of this year. You can see that we've doubled our sales last year and we intend to double them again this year. And now, in the last 3 months, we've been focusing mainly on the second step of our monetization plan. We approached several online grocery retailers who also seek ways to engage with their audience in new ways, because Amazon is entering the grocery market and everyone is concerned about it. And I'm very proud to announce that just last month we signed our first two partnership agreements, one with Peapod, a large US-based online supermarket chain with 40 million orders turnover, and the other is Delivery.com, a leading New York City delivery service with more than 10,000 businesses on board, to run a pilot where we would drive the grocery orders to their platform from the grocery list users generate on our app for a commission fee that we take on each transaction. Where do we intend to go next? So we could continue growing organically in a bootstrap manner like we did so far, but we want to scale now much, much faster. And why do we do that? Well, because we believe we can become the market leader of this personal recipe space. And for that, we are looking for seed investment now. What are we going to do with the money? In terms of product, we're going to expand to more platforms, Android and web. You can see our Android app is already in progress. We are already working on it. And then complete our technology and algorithms. In terms of market, we intend to use a large part of the seed investment for marketing budget and grow our audience very quickly and reach more than 1 million users by the end of the seed round. In order to do that, when we'll do that, we'll have much stronger value proposition for the business partners, and we will be able to extend our pilot to more supermarket chains and more businesses that use recipes as part of their business model. For that, we are looking for 750,000 seed investment. As you can see, most of it goes into marketing and business development, again, because the goal is scaling. Finally, let me introduce our team. So my name is Rachel. I'm the founder, I'm CEO. I started this whole idea. I'm a physicist by education and a mobile developer for many years, and I also have marketing background from an MBA degree I have. Michael, our CTO, is a very experienced and knowledgeable software developer. He can basically code out of sleep. Chaim is a business executive with an entrepreneurial background who joined us recently to lead our business development activity. So if you want to see a live demo and if you want to hear more about our plan to become the market leader of personal recipes, come talk to us. We are here at the booth. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Rachel, or Rachel, as I try to say. So, two questions here. Question that just keeps coming in is, okay, but, what about all these cool applications, Evernote, Dropbox, that are capable of, recognizing, organizing documents and so on? How do you compete with those?
Google Keep, for example, yes. Well, they are very great services indeed. They scan documents, they do OCR, but they're not recipe adapted. They won't find the ingredients part out of your document. They won't export it into a grocery list or a meal plan. So they're great for every document except for recipes. And we are.
Now, but, you claim you're already profitable, right? So what's the key reason investors here should be putting money in your company? Why do you need these guys?
You're right. We already have money. But we want to grow much faster now because we think there is an opportunity in this market. It's a very large market with millions of food blogs and recipe apps and magazines and this huge industry with no clear market leader yet. And in the internet world, as we saw it so far, This eventually happens to every vertical. Comes one player who takes it all. And it didn't happen with recipes yet. So we think there is a great opportunity open here, and that's why we want to grab it and scale our business fast and become that one market leader.
And good luck with becoming a market leader there. Thank you, Raquel.
Thank you.